बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, माय नेम इज़ मिस मैविश हारिस एंड आई एम योर मैथ्स टीचर फ्रॉम पिशावर मॉडल स्कूल। इट इज़ ओवर 16 लेक्चर एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द रियल नंबर्स। सो यू ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट द रियल नंबर्स, बट इन ओवर दिस लेक्चर वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द टॉपिक स्क्वेयर रूट, क्यूब एंड क्यूब रूट, एंड ऑल्सो डूइंग द एक्सरसाइज विच आर रिलेटेड to these topic. So my dear student, before starting the topic square root, first of all you know about what is meant by square. Square means when a number is multiplied by itself, the result is called square of the given number. For example, 4 square is equal to 4 multiplied by 4, that is equal to 16. Then 16 is called the square of 4. Now take another example. 5 square is equal to 5 multiplied by 5, which is equal to 25. So 25 is called square of 5. Same as the case, so today our topic is square root. So square root is an opposite of square. So my dear student, square root means the square root of a number is a number which when squared give the same number. The symbol square root is used to denote the square root, and the symbol of square root is used, the symbol which we used for finding the square root is called radical, and the value of radical is 1/2. So what is meant by radical? The symbol of square root which are used for finding square root is called radical, and the value of the radical is 1/2, and the number which are written inside the radical is known as the radicand. For example, the square root of 25 is 5. However, I will say that the square root of 25 is 5 because whenever we have to finding the square root of 25, we can write here the factors 5 multiplied by 5, which is equal to 25. So 5 is multiplied 2 times. I will write here 5 square. So we have to find the square root. That's why we have to put the sign of the radical, and the value of radical is 1/2. So this square, 5 square, this square should be cut by the value of the radical, which is 1/2. So again 5 is left. It's mean whenever we have to finding the square root of 25, our answer is 5. So square and square root are opposite of each other. Whenever we have to find the square of 5, our answer is 25, and whenever we have to finding the square root of 25, our answer is 5. So these are the opposite of each other. So my dear student, there are two methods of finding square root. The first method is square root by factorization method, and the second method is square root by the division method. You already know how we can solve the square root by factorization method. So at that time we have to learn and understand how we have to simplify square root by the division method. So our question number 1 is find the square root of the following. We have to find the square root by the division method. So first question is 784. Now my dear student, let us start how we have to solve the square root by the division method. Before starting the division method, we must have to make the drill of the square table. You know about what is meant by square table. Square table means 1 multiplied by 1 equal to 1, 2 multiplied by 2 equal to 4, 3 multiplied by 3 equal to 9, 4 multiplied by 4 equal to 16, 5 multiplied by 5 equal to 25, 6 multiplied by 6 equal to 36, 7 multiplied by 7 equal to 49, 8 multiplied by 8 equal to 64, up to so on. You have to make the table of square table and make the drill of this square table again and again. It should be helpful in solving the square root by division method. So group of these two numbers, we have to make the numbers into group. And how can we make the pair of the digit? We have to make the pair of the digits from right to the left. From right to the left. So our first step is we have to pair the digit from right to the left. So the first pair is 84 and the next is 7. Now our next step is we have to find the number whose square is less than the given number. We have to find the square in our square table whose square is less than the given number. Let's suppose 2 multiply by 2 equal to 4. So 4 is less than 7. Now try another number like 3 multiply by 3 equal to 9. So 9 is greater than 4. So we have to take the smaller number, that is 2 multiply by 2 equal to 4. So you have to write here or 2 multiply by 2, that is equal to 4. So we have to write here like this, 2 multiply by 2 equal to 4. Now it should be subtract it from 7. 7 minus 4, which is equal to 3. We put here 3. Then we have to double this number. Double this number, 2 plus 2 equal to 4. Or if you not do addition, you will be multiplied 2 by 2. So 2 multiply by 2 equal to 4. So by this we have to double this number. After doubling this number, below we have to write here 4. Then we have to finding the digits in like in different pair. We have to put 2. Whenever we have to multiply 2 by 2 in pair form, we get 84. So we don't need 84, we have to need 384. Then we have to write here 7 minus 4, which is equal to 3. Next pair of the digit is 84. We have to put and write it below. So the digit should become 384. And we have already double up the number. 2 up to 2, that is equal to 4. Now we have to find the another pair which we have to multiply it and got the product of 384. So which number we have to find here? We apply here the pair like 2, like 3, like 6, like 7. Now we have to apply the pair 8. Now we have to multiply it, then number, then twice the quotient, 2 multiply by 2 equal to 4, and bring down the next pair, which is 48. So now we have to finding the number 8. Before finding the number 8, you have to search about 6, you have to search about 4 and many others numbers, such that we have to find here whenever we have to multiply 48 with 8, you got the product 384. So it is our required number and the remainder is 0. It means the square root of 784 is 28. We can also check it either our question answer is correct or not by taking the square. Whenever we have to take the square of 28, our answer is 784. And whenever we have to finding the square root of 784, our answer is 28. So very simple. The first step is pair the digit from right to the left. We have to start it from unit places and then we have to going to the higher places. Now the first one is 7. We have to find the pair whose square is less than the given number, that is 4. So 2 multiply by 2 equal to 4. Now we have to take that 4 is less than 7. So subtract it from 7, which is equal to 3. Now twice the quotient, we have to twice over quotient and double up the quotient and write it below and bring down the next pair. So we have to write here 7 minus 4, which is equal to 3, and write down the next pair, that is 48. Now we have to finding the number 8. Before finding the number 8, we have to search about 4, 6 and many in rest of the numbers. So whenever we have to multiply 48 with 8, our product is 384. So remainder should be 0 and the quotient of and the square root of 784 is 28. So this is the required method which you have to learn about square root by division method. Now come to the next topic, which is known as cube and cube root. So cube, what is meant by cube? Which is very simple, any number which is a product of three identical number is called a cube. Square means product of two identical number, and the cube means any number which is a product of how many numbers? Three identical numbers. Identical means same, is called a cube. For example, 27 is a cube of 3, means whenever we have to multiply 3 times, our answer is 27. It's mean 3 multiply by 3 multiply by 3, which is equal to 27. So 27 is called the cube of 3. You can also find the cube of 2. Like 2 cube means 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2. So our answer is 8. So 8 is a cube of 2. Now our question is, find cube of the following. The first part is 16. How can we find the cube? Which is very simple. Taking 16 cube. Cube means 3. So it's mean 3 identical number, that are 16 multiply by 16 multiply by 16. You can easily split up the numbers into two forms. So 16 multiply by 16, which is equal to 256. Then again we have to multiply 256 with 16. So the right answer is, the cube of 16 is 4096. You can easily do multiplication in rough work. So 16 cube means 16 multiply by 16 multiply by 16, which is equal to 4096. Our next question is 6. Again we have to find the cube. 6 cube equal to 6 multiply by 6 multiply by 6. Easily you have to solve here. 6 times 36. Again multiply 6 with 36. The answer of 6 cube is equal to 216. So cube is very simple. Now come to the topic cube root. The cube root of a number x is denoted by 3 radical. Let's suppose any other numbers. Cube of positive number is also positive, whereas that of a negative number is negative. Let's suppose we have to find and solve the cube root of 343. How can we solve the cube root of 343? By the factorization method. 7 multiply by 49, you got 343. Again it should we take the prime number, that is 7. 7 multiply by 7, you got 49. Then 7 1 times 7. So how many times 7 is multiplied? It should be multiplied 3 times. 7 multiply by 7 multiply by 7. So 7 cube. It's mean the value of this sign is, the value of the cube root is 1 by 3. Remember my students that the power of square root is 1 by 2, whereas the power and the value of the cube root is 1 by 3. So 3 multiply by 1 by 3, it should be cut by each other, and your answer is, your cube root of 343 is 7. You can easily check it. How is your answer correct or not? 7 multiply by 7 multiply by 7, your product is 343. So my dear student, your homework is, you have to complete exercise 2.3 and 2.4 with the help of these definitions and with the help of these questions. Thank you.